Good morning, everyone, and thank you, Dean, and thank you, Gustavo, for inviting me to this very warm and hospitable country. Thank you. I am Michael Cook. I am from the north of the United States, and I come from a cheese family. I have coached international basketball, and I have been a leader in the grain, oilseeds, and rice industries, or I've been CEO of several firms. For the last 20 years, I have returned to academia, where I am a researcher, where I am paid to listen, analyze, and share my observations. For the past 2 days, we have had the pleasure of listening to some very, very creative and courageous leaders in your agribusiness sector. What we have listened to is we observed examples of attempts to confront day-to-day challenges of increased market concentration, increased quality and health standards, increased risk caused by increasing globalization of product, input, capital, and foreign exchange markets. And we have listened to how transaction costs create inefficiencies in transacting in this country and in foreign countries. We also observed heroic attempts to develop sophisticated risk management tools and strategies to overcome these challenges. Again, these challenges to survive on a daily basis. But underneath, as I listened or tried to listen carefully, I detected or I observed an underlying concern by these leaders about global and food situation that bothers or challenges all of us. These concerns included a rising food insecurity and hunger throughout the world. They also observed that world poverty is still primarily rural. Third, they expressed concerns about the increasing rural-urban income disparity, and it's growing. They also shared concerns about increasing resource scarcity and environmental degradation. And finally, they expressed their concerns about the undersupply of human resources to address these firm-level regional, national, and international challenges. This should be an interesting challenge for the higher education and all education participants here today. Now, what do we do about these challenges? What can you do? What can institutions such as La Universidad de los Andes do? I am just arriving from China, where 1,500 economists and social scientists met to look at or listen, debate, analyze this very complex set of challenges. And the conclusion or the summary when we left Beijing were two. One, this situation, this challenge is so complex, we need to, number one, reconceptualize our approach. We need scholarship to inform trade-offs between food and agriculture growth and national development. We need to set priorities regarding ag and food growth. And we need to refine the relative roles of state, the market, and civil society. So this reconceptualization was the first challenge that we need to deal with. The conclusion of that group was the economic development policies regarding agriculture over the last 20 years on a global basis have almost been non-existent. Some of you are old enough to remember the 60s and 70s. There was much attention to food and agriculture. But in the 80s and 90s and up until 2005, very little attention given to this global sector. The second conclusion of this conference was that we need to redesign our approaches. The first was to reconceptualize. The second is to redesign. We need to experiment, evaluate, identify, and compare our approaches to achieve desired development functions. We need credible, this is a very important word, credible commitments by governments, non-governmental agencies, international agencies, and yes, private firms to raise the output of our thinking about these major food and agriculture challenges. And third, we need institutional innovations to redefine the shape of governance needed for the food and agriculture sectors to achieve the development functions. That will be the topic of, I think, the first session this afternoon. Now, as I look around this room, I'm sure I am looking at the core group that will take the leadership in reconceptualizing and redefining our approaches to these challenges, not only in Colombia, but this region and internationally. Thank you for your attention.